problem. Issues every day. I'm facing every day. And every day I'm
LaToya Sanders, and I'm your host. My co-host isn't here today. He wasn't able to make it. We are actually taping in Kilgore, Texas at the Holy Convocation. Yes, yes. We have an awesome show for you guys today. We have the great, chosen by God, recording artist. Yes. These guys, they're actually recording artists, and like I said, they're called Chosen by God. Go ahead, introduce yourselves.
I am Marion Sanders.
Sylvia Hawthorne.
Emma Hawthorne.
Okay, tell me we taping with a live audience, but they don't sound live, do they? tell us something about that. How did you guys come up with the name Chosen by God?
I think we came up with the name about almost 8 years ago. Well, I'm gonna say maybe a little bit longer than that. We've been singing officially around 8 years, but I think we had our first engagement at a church, at a hotel. I'm not really sure, it was so long ago. But we said, okay, we can't just be called the Hawthorne Sisters, because the Hawthorne Sisters is country. Amen. The name Hawthorne is country. So we said we need to come up with a name that sounds, you know, that's befitting us. Right, yeah. And so just in discussing that, we decided to call ourselves Chosen by God. Even at that time, when we selected that name, I can't say that we really understood the meaning of being chosen by God, but God knows what he's doing. And so when we got that name, it wasn't until maybe a few years later that we figured out, through the tests and trials and the heartaches and the situations, yes, we are definitely chosen by God.
Yes, yes, yes. As you sit here and talk about chosen by God, I'm reminded of the scripture, many are called, but few are chosen. There are only a few people that can really sing under the anointing. You know, it's one thing to sing a gospel song, but to sing under the anointing is a totally different thing. How do you guys focus and concentrate and maintain that anointing?
Through prayer and fasting. Right. Praying and fasting. We fall short because we don't really get it done all the time, but we know when we have to go minister, we have to pray. We have to fast. And the flesh doesn't like fasting. I know sometimes I don't either, but right, it's something that we have to do.
Oh, yes, yes. So you said you guys have been singing about 8 years, is that correct?
Officially as a group, 8 years. It really started out when we were born. In the bathroom with the brushes and the combs, right, and all of that, making up songs and all of that. That's really when it started. But we officially started going out a little bit over 8 years, just singing out of different churches in our neighborhood.
Tell me this. I actually was able to read your bio, and you guys have really sang with a lot of professional artists. Tell us something about that.
Well, they sung with God's Property. I was pretty much, you know, to myself really. So, but we've been able to sing on various stages with Myron Williams performed and different things like that, conventions and things like that. So I wasn't really just the, you know, singing with, but right, these two, she sings with Myron Butler and Levi now.
Oh, really?
You know, just to broaden herself and help broaden us at the same time.
How do you stay dedicated? Because a lot of times people think that, well, you're just singing or you're just rapping, when really it takes a lot of dedication. It takes a lot of discipline. I like to push that this Christian walk is a process. It's not something that happens overnight. You didn't become recording artist overnight. You know, it's something that you had to concentrate on, something that you had to stay disciplined with. Tell us, how do you maintain that?
I think for me, as the leader of the group, the word comes to mind, passion.
Right.
Passion. There are going to be some times, and even now, there are times where it looks easier to just give it up, you know. But there's passion inside, and then there's vision inside that keeps you just going on. And then again, we're going to fall back to the name. When you feel like giving up, you can't, you know. It's all about really realizing who you are. Once you realize that you are chosen, then it means you don't have a choice.
Right, right, right. It's already been made.
So that pretty much maintains us and help us get back into keep things in perspective and not give up so easy.
Do you guys have any upcoming events or programs scheduled so far?
We actually have out of town events coming up in San Antonio and Kansas. I think that's all I can remember on my schedule. Yeah, coming up real soon.
Right, right. So, Chosen by God, did you all start together? I hear you saying that you were really not involved when they were singing with God's Property. You were kind of just...
I mean, we started together as a group, but, you know, as we got older, you know, I guess it really didn't bother me not to be able to sing, you know, whatever. So, that's when they just, you know, ventured out, you know, to learn different things and try different things. You know, so that's pretty much.
I'll add to that so we can get clarification. We've always sang. We've always sang at church periodically. What happened was God's Property had, I think Kelly and I were at a Kirk Franklin concert, and we heard God's Property sing, and I saw them that following weekend at Denny's, and I introduced myself to them, and I eventually auditioned that the week of my birthday. I was turning 15, and so it was me that went out, and I didn't go out because we weren't really singing as a group, but when I joined God's Property, what that did for us was open up a whole lot of more doors. Mind you, I was 15, so you had to be in what, 13, 12, one of the two, and so that opened up a lot more doors where we would be able to. It was then that Emma came in and started singing with God's Property, and at the time there weren't any more openings for altos, but it didn't affect what we were doing. It actually just added to and enhanced because of the experience that we've gained singing on the Bobby Jones Show, singing behind different artists, learning the do's and don'ts, the ins and outs, you know, the pros and cons, the disadvantages and the advantages. What we were able to do was just take that and apply it to us being a group now. So it was actually me that went out. We were just church girls. Just church girls. And so God's Property was the first real outside of the church event that I took a part of. So that opened up doors for us.
Let me ask you this, because a lot of times as I go through different communities and whatever, we find a lot of kids that are not able to maintain. As far as what I mean by maintain is, I mean they're not able to stay focused when it comes to this Christian walk. You said you were 15, maybe 12. How did you not get off into different things? How did you stay on the course?
So you did.
We